What is the difference between local storage and session storage?
So basically, local storage and session storage both are used to store data into the browser. So local storage, basically the data stored in local storage doesn't get deleted whenever we close the browser. That means the data doesn't get automatically deleted. Once we will open the browser back, we will see that the data stored in the local storage is still there. But in case of a session storage, once we open a tab and the data is stored into the session storage, whenever the tab gets closed, the session storage data will get automatically deleted. And you won't be able to access it after the tab gets closed. And the second difference is that in case of a local storage, suppose I opened youtube.com and I set some data into the local storage like check equals to 2. And I I open some other tab similar youtube.com and try to access the data stored in the first tab. So in case of a local storage, I would be able to access the data into the new tab as well. The data set in the first tab would be accessible in the other tab of youtube.com as well. But in case of a session storage, the data is private to the tab only. Suppose I opened facebook.com, I set some data to the session storage and opened a new tab of facebook.com and tried to access the data which I have set in the first tab in the second tab. But I will see that I won't be able to access that data. That means the data stored in the session storage is private to that tab only. And the last difference is basically about the storage capacities, that in case of browser storage, we will be able to store up from 5 MBs to 10 MBs of data. Basically, it is browser dependent. And in case of a session storage, we will only be able to store up to 5 MBs of data. So that's all from my side.
So why is React so popular?
The reason of popularity of React is that React is much faster compared to other frameworks like Angular. So the reason is the concept of using virtual DOM. So basically, what virtual DOM is? Virtual DOM is a carbon copy of the real DOM, and virtual DOM is stored inside the memory. So whenever some components are changed, they are first reflected to the virtual DOM, and then algorithm calculates the difference between the virtual DOM and the real DOM so that it can detect which component have been changed, and only those component are changed in the real DOM. So basically, this thing makes React very much faster compared to other framework. And other reason which make React popular is 1-way data binding. So 1-way data binding says that data will always flow in one direction from parent towards child. And this thing makes the debugging of the application very easy, because anything happens, we will first look into the parent component and look over the data flow and check where the bug is. And another thing is like reusable component. In case of a React, everything is a component. So I can give you an example of like youtube.com. So in case of youtube.com, you see a navbar is there, a sidebar is there. And so in case of YouTube, the navbar is a particular component, the sidebar is a particular component. So whenever we need the navbar, we don't write the code again and again. We just create the navbar component once and then call it wherever we need it. So this reusability of component make React more popular compared to other framework. And another thing that React is a client-side library. So basically, it is running on the client side, which make it more faster. And a final reason is JSX. So basically, JSX is JavaScript and XML. It give us the power to write HTML inside JavaScript, which make component more readable. So the developer would be able to write the logic as well as the HTML part in a single component. So these things make React more popular compared to other frameworks.
Nice. And differentiate state and props.
So props are basically used to transfer data from one component to another component, basically from the parent component to child component. And in case of a state is basically a internal storage of a component where the component can store its data. Props are generally, we can say they are immutable, because a child component cannot change a prop, but in case of a state, they are mutable. State generally contain a data which can change over time, so states are generally mutable. And props make component reusable. Basically, for example, suppose I have a button, suppose it's a subscribe button. It is basically of red color, and whenever a user clicks on it, it turns into white color. So we want to reuse the same button component twice. So using props we can achieve this? We can take a parent component, and inside the parent component we are calling the button component, and inside the button we will pass the prop and an object saying the color equals to red. That means initially the prop is passing as color equals to red, the color of the button would be red. But whenever the user clicks on the button, we can change the prop value to color equals to white. So now the same button have previously have the color red, and whenever the user clicked on it, the same button color changed to white. In this way, the prop promotes reusability. And as in case of a state cannot be accessed by other components. State is internal only, and props are external. So these were some of the differences I know.
Tell me, have you used hooks?
Yes, I have used hooks.
Okay. Differentiate use memo and use.
Basically, use memo and use callback both are used to increase the performance of a React application. Both are similar in case of a syntax. Both take a callback function initially, and as a second argument, both take the dependencies. So use memo is generally used to memoize a value, but use effect is used to memoize a function. So we use memo when we want to memoize a value. Suppose we have a function which calculates a Fibonacci number, and we know as the greater the input will be. Suppose we want to find the 100th Fibonacci number. In that case, if the function is implemented with recursive approach, then it will take a lot of time as well as computation to calculate what the 100th Fibonacci number is. So to solve this problem, what we can do, we can memoize the Fibonacci function. So in that case, what it will do, it will memoize that for 100th input, the output is this. So whenever we check what the 100th Fibonacci number is, it won't compute it again and again. It will just check its cache storage, and from its cache storage, it will directly get the output value. Thus, it will save a lot of computation and increase the performance of the React application. But similarly, in case of callback, the callback memoize a function. Why do we require to memoize a function? Suppose we have a parent component. Inside the parent component, we have another child component. Once the parent component get re-rendered due to some reason, the child component will also get re-rendered. We will see that parent component is re-rendering because state had changed or some reasons. But why is the child component getting re-rendered? Suppose the child component is very big. Then if the child component will unusually re-render again and again, that might cause an optimization issue. So to prevent this, we generally use the memo to memoize the child function. And suppose we pass a prop from the parent component to the child component, then and also we will see that the child component is getting re-rendered again and again with the parent component. So to resolve this problem, we use callback function in conjunction with use memo. So use callback will make sure that whenever the props get changed, in that case it will re-render the child component. But whenever the props doesn't get changed, it will stop the child component from re-rendering again and again. So ma'am, this was all I know.